Have you ever heard of persistence or persistent chemicals? Let's try to understand together what that means. In the dictionary, persistence is described as a quality that exists for a continuous or prolonged period of time. In chemistry, substances are described as persistent on the basis of the time it takes for them to break down, or, to use a more accurate term, degrade. Several factors can contribute to the degradation of a chemical substance in our ecosystem. Scientists divide these factors into two groups, whether they are living or not. Examples of non-living or abiotic factors include sunlight, temperature, water, and reactive compounds in the atmosphere. Living organisms who help break down a chemical substance include bacteria and fungi and are called biotic. Degradation from biotic or biological factors is often referred to as biodegradation. In short, chemical substances that break down quickly are called degradable. Those that are resistant to degradation are called persistent. And who decides how slowly they must degrade to be labeled as persistent or not? While scientists provide data on the behavior of different chemicals, it is up to regulators at national and international level to decide what amount of time can be considered acceptable and to draw the line which separates persistent and non-persistent chemical substances. How do scientists check if a substance is degradable? Several laboratory test methods can be performed to assess the degradability of chemicals. These tests measure how the concentration of that chemical decreases when it's exposed to biotic or abiotic factors, and how long this process takes. A common value that scientists look for in a substance is called its dissipation half-life, which is the time it takes for its concentration to decrease by 50%. But, in the end, why does it matter if a substance is persistent or not? Well, it matters because if a substance is persistent, it remains in the environment, unaltered, for a long time. On top of it, it could be transported by air or water, for example, and travel extremely long distances, ending up in very remote areas, such as the polar regions. In some cases, research has shown that some persistent chemicals can also accumulate in animals and humans, potentially posing health risks to them. But if they are so bad, why are they being produced? Well, persistent chemicals can become a problem when they end up accumulating where they shouldn't. In these cases, researchers need to look for alternatives that break down more quickly and completely in the environment whilst achieving their intended function. But sometimes persistence can also be a desirable quality in a substance because it makes objects that contain it resistant and durable. Think of optic fibers that transport data across continents under the ocean. They have to be durable and resist for a long period of time. Otherwise, they wouldn't serve their purpose. Here's another example. When you buy a new bicycle or a new car, you don't want their color to fade after a few weeks or months. Well, it's the persistent quality of the color pigments in its shiny paint that allows your ride to look the same for years, even if it's exposed to sunlight, rain, or adverse weather conditions. So, is it clearer now what persistence is when it comes to chemical substances? Persistence is the characteristic that makes chemical substances resistant and durable over extended periods of time.